What's up guys, Sal here. So we're 8 months away from the launch of the Galaxy S22 lineup, yet the handset keeps making headlines in the tech world, partially due to the fact that the phone will be the first handset in the world to feature new graphics from AMD. AMD at the Computex already confirmed that the new Exynos chipset will get high-end gaming features found on the PS5 and Xbox Series X. Those are ray tracing and variable rate shading, which should help it carve out a place amongst the upper echelons of the best gaming phones. So we know the Galaxy S22 will feature powerful graphics, but what we don't know is how it stacks up against the best and the most powerful phones out there. Well, that changes today as this AMD GPU has appeared in a GPU benchmarking site called 3DMark. Ice Universe tweeted that Samsung is currently testing the AMD GPU on Exynos, and it scores 8,134 on the wildlife test on 3DMark, which is the highest score a smartphone was able to achieve on the benchmarking site. They're using a 2-year-old Cortex A77 CPU for this test and not the latest ones that ARM unveiled recently. So the final chipset could offer even better graphics performance as the latest Cortex X2 and Cortex A710 CPU cores are much faster than the Cortex A77 cores used in this test. Anyway, it also shows the average frame rate as 50, which again is the highest for any smartphone. Now, how does this compare to the latest Snapdragon 888, Exynos 2100, and Apple's A14 Bionic? Well, the Snapdragon-equipped Galaxy S21 Ultra has a score of 5,177 and 31 frames per second, while the Exynos 2100 variant has a score of 5,295. It's remarkable just how far the divide is between the AMD GPU and the current Android chipsets. Notably, the new Samsung chip also beats Apple's A14 Bionic chip, which scored 7,668 with an average frame rate of 40 frames per second. Interestingly, the M1 chipset scored around 17,000 points in this test. That's almost twice as much. But the thing is, M1 will never make it to the iPhones because it's meant for much bigger devices with more room for cooling and heat dissipation. Now, a good GPU and even the CPU on a smartphone is one that doesn't see many performance drop-offs. Snapdragon chips are good in this as they have a great sustained performance. Apple is known to target peak over sustained performance when it comes to the GPU, so the performance drops when you play games for an extended period of time on iPhones is high. Now, whether or not AMD takes Snapdragon's approach or Apple's approach will remain to be seen. But nonetheless, it's good to see an Android chipset beating Apple's best smartphone chipset in graphic performance. Samsung is expected to announce its new Exynos chip in July, and right now the chip is an absolute beast, elevating the gaming level of Android phones to an all-time high. Some more official images of the Galaxy Z Flip 3 that show the handset in different colors. Nothing here is really surprising as we already know how these devices are supposed to look. But what's interesting though is that the cover display shows August 11th, which seems like the official unpacked event date as the device's display in the renders usually mentions the exact date of its launch event. So the past info about them keeping an event on August 3rd is probably not true. Of course, do consider subscribing for all the latest news in the tech world. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.